So, sixth graders, here's some more examples from lesson 6-3 on multiplying mixed numbers. Okay, Emily, we left off with you. You have to change this mixed number to a top-heavy fraction before multiplying. So, tell us what to do. How about just, okay, go ahead. Let's start with this one.
8 times 3 is 4.
Yeah.
+1 is 5.
Where's the +1 come from?
The numerator.
Good. You add the numerator. So you do a whole number times denominator. You can write this answer right underneath it, so you don't have to do it in your head. And then add the numerator, which is 25 then, over what? 3. We keep the denominator. 25 over 3. Okay? And multiply that by 3/5. Yep. Now, do we have to change this one?
No.
Why not?
It's already a top-heavy fraction.
Is it a top-heavy fraction?
It's not.
It's just a regular fraction, okay? But we have to make sure that we change mixed numbers to top-heavy fractions, okay? Now, are there any common factors? Roy?
What?
Are there any common factors?
Common factors?
Yeah, look at these. Look at the numbers diagonally. Can we reduce these numbers? Do 25 and 5 have common factors?
Yeah.
What?
5 and 5. 5.
So if we take out the 5s, how many 5s are in 1 5?
How many 5s are in 1 5?
1.
1, good. How many 5s are in 25?
5.
5. So cross it out 25 and write 5. That's how you factor out the 5s. What could be factored out of these numbers, Nate?
3 times 3.
What can we factor out?
1 times 3.
We could take out the 3s. They both have 3s. How many 3s? Nate?
2.
No, each one. Do each one separately, okay? 1 3 and 1 3. 1 3. Very good. Now we can multiply the numbers that are left. These are the numbers that are left. 5 times 1 and 1 times 1. What's the answer? What's the answer? Ariana? Times 1 is 5 over 1, so that's just 5. Okay, let's do another one. Let's skip to number 13. 4 2/5. Number 13. 4 2/5 times 1 1/2. Whoa. Skipping around on me. Okay, what do we have to do now? Lindsay? Anything else? Abby?
Yes, the 22 and 2.
you can factor out the, what? The twos, yep. There's one, two, and... 11. Yep. So these are the numbers left. 11 times 3. Brett?
33.
And 5 times 1.
5.
Now we have to change that back to a mixed number. Daria, what do we have to do to change it back to a mixed number?
You
do 11 times 5
equals 33.
Yeah. What would it be? 6. 6 times. Good. Yep. So what we'll do is 6 times 5 is 30 minus what we started with gives us the remainder. 33 minus 30. Where does the 30 come from, Roy?
Where does the 30 come from? Mm-hmm.
Where did we get 30? Where did I get this 30? Five goes into 33.
Six times.
6 times 5 is
30.
Now we can find the remainder. You can do 33 minus 30, which is
3.
And what do we write at the bottom?
5.
6 3/5 is the answer. Okay. Right.
I do it a different way though.
Well. Do you show it a different way?
Yeah.
You can show it a different way. How do you show it?
Well, I like, I did 5 times 4 plus 2, and then I find something that goes that like I do the it times 3, 20 times 3. Yeah, 22 times 3.
Okay, so you didn't factor it out first.
Yeah, and then I divide.
And that's okay. You don't have to factor it out first, but you might end up multiplying by really big numbers when you wouldn't have to.
Yeah.
And it's important to look at 22 and 2 and to see that there are a common factor. They have a common factor. Do you see the common factor in those?
Yeah.
All right. So I want you to be able to do that. That'll be important for later on, and it makes it a little easier to do now, is to factor out those common factors. Okay? I'll get to you in a second, Ethan. If you guys are finished with your test, hand them in. Okay, let's go on. Let's do one more. Number 17. We're going to do number 17 today. And that one has 3 numbers. How do you multiply 3 numbers? 3 1/5 times 1 5/6. Times 3/10. Okay. How do we multiply 3 numbers? Max?
You have to turn the 2 numbers into a property fraction.
Good. Let's do that. Let's start with that. So this is 15 plus 1, which is
16
over 5 times
1 times 6 is 6 plus 5 is 11, and then your denominator is 6.
Good. And the last one, Tyler.
3/10.
3/10. Just keep it as 3/10. Okay. Now, here's something that we can do. If two of them have common factors, we can factor those out. Okay? But once you factor one, you can't factor the same number again unless it has another factor that we can use. Okay? So here's what I mean. Everybody pay attention to this. Look at these two numbers. Do they have a common factor?
No.
They're both what?
Even.
Even, yeah.
Yeah, if they're both even, what's in both? Twos, right? Factor out the twos. Yeah, we'd be left with, since when you think of 16, when we did this, 2 and 8, there's a 2 in there, right? What's left if we factor out the 2s? What's left? An 8. If you factor the number 6, you get 2 and 3. If you cross off the 2, you are left with 3. Okay? Now, look at this. You can factor the 3 and this 3, can't you? Can you factor that now? Yeah. How many 3s? 1. Now, is there anything else we can factor?
No.
We can't factor 5 and 10, can we?
No.
Why not? In order to do that, you have to have Brett.
Well, they're both denominators, and you can only do
either diagonal or up and down. You can't factor them if they're on the same level. Okay? So now we can multiply. 8 times 11, 88. There we go. 88. And 5 times 1 times 10 is 50. 88 fiftieths. We could reduce that. Oh, you know what? We could have factored 8 and 10, couldn't we? Oh, well. 88 fiftieths. Divide them both by 2 because they're both even. So that's 44 25ths. Any common, anything in there? Nope. As a mixed number, how many times would 25 go into 44?
Once.
So 44 minus 25 is the remainder. What's 44 minus 25? Anybody know? Abby?
19.
So this would be, it'd go in one time and it'd be 19 over 25, right? 1 and 19 25ths. So there's just one where you have to do three numbers, right? There's one that you have to do three numbers. Okay, there's some examples for you. We're going to do a little bit more practice for tomorrow on these.